I'm Rich Slayton, and this is your top 10 plays from the 2020 Clash Royale League World Finals. Leading things off, it's Ruben, who was a leader in gameplay throughout the entire event, and this was no exception. Up against Ponos with a great bit of work right here. Heal Spirit and then Barb Barrel right behind the Zappies. And of course, that reset on the Princess Tower retargets to the Barb Barrel, and in comes a ton of damage. This is the kind of micro that let Ruben lead his squad to that world championship. Our number 9 play, CRS of Nova Esports, up against Lucas of Pain Gaming. And check out the bait here. Yeah, of course those barbarians distract the Inferno Dragon, but they force out the fireball, and of course CRS doubles down. Skeleton Dragons, Flying Machine, Lava Pups, Miner, and a ton all over the tower, and of course that is tower down. Great bit of fireball bait usage from CRS. Our number 8 play, KK of Ponos Esports, a longtime veteran of the league with some veteran moves here against IMJP. The NATO used to defend against the balloon with the Ice Whiz, but JP's back to another balloon and currently has that damage lead. So KK goes with the graveyard fireball into the left-hand lane, gets a lot of damage, and just barely holds on against the balloon. It does not take tower, and that's a big win for KK, of course. Team Queso comes back. More from this matchup later, but you can see hearts pumping. KK knows how close that one was. On to number 7, LCOP, one of the best to ever play the game, with a great bit of micro here to get every single bit of value out of this magic archer. And check that out, you're not reading it wrong. That is now 10 shots on tower from the magic archer. The log to reset some of those troops, great micro, and then check this out. The miner comes in, and the NATO makes a boulder retarget to the miner, so there's a connection with the wall breakers, and of course, how else will LCOP finish off this tower? But with more magic archer play, GG, well played from multiple time champion LCOP. On to our number 6 play, Western champion, SK Gaming from 2019, on that road trying to get back to the finals. Here with Morton up against Solaman of WEDGM. And Morton is just barely in the lead, but has so much to defend against here in the final 30. But check out this Hunter. The Knight pushes it up. It does not give enough room. And that Hunter just barely defends that tower by 26 HP. Big win for SK Gaming. On to our number 5 play, the golden-haired golden boy from Barcelona, Spain, facing elimination in the championship game. This would be a win for SK Gaming, and the prediction Barb Barrel gets a huge Royal Giant connection on that right-hand side, and JP cycles right back around, gets to another Royal Giant right about here, and there you have it. I am JP facing elimination. Clutch moment comes through huge for Team Queso and keeps their hopes alive for at least one more fifth and final set. And talking about keeping your hopes alive, Wallace, the absolute hero for Pain Gaming, went 7-1 against Nova Esports, and this might be the most impressive of all those 7. Behind on damage, balloon coming down that left-hand lane, in a whole lot of trouble, and Wallace just barely gets down this beautiful defensive freeze just in the proper range with 4-3-2-1, and look at that. By a hair, Wallace beats Nova Esports and sends Pain Gaming onto the semifinals. Very, very well played. A marquee moment for the young man out of Brazil. Speaking about young men, Mugi, one of the most anticipated rookies of 2020, up against Jupiter King. Also, one of the most anticipated rookies of 2020. And this was a back and forth battle. Just like that, Jupiter King has taken the lead back from Mugi with just 90 seconds left. But check out the work here by Mugi. Goes bowler at the bridge, graveyard, and while this goblin cage seems like that should be enough with the poison to defend against all of this, look at the fancy footwork here. NATO lines all that up, the longer rage from the bowler, gets that damage on the right-hand tower, and that is a massive moment. Mugi doubles down, and again, it seems like Jupiter King should have this well enough defended, but Mugi gets creative, freeze in the last moment, keeping the baby dragon alive, enough time to put the pressure on, get the graveyard poison in, and get a big-time sweep win for his squad and move them on beyond Tribe Gaming in the semis. Speaking of young men who everyone's looking at, Ruben has become, without question, one of the top, if not the top player on the planet. And this event put him in the same situation over and over again, facing elimination, down in the fifth and final set, being forced to clutch up. And he clutched up big in this one. Gets a nice catch against the miner, recognizes here that that Lava Hound is a bit of an overcommitment, so Ruben goes in heavy on the left-hand side. Gets really, really aggressive. Skeleton Dragon gets on tower, and check out this foot race. The arrows out of Hajime just can't do it. Ruben gets the big time win for Team Queso, as he did over and over again to become the world champion. Back to that Team Queso-Ponos matchup, and this is the one everyone wanted to see. Moogie and Ruben, this is the dream. Best of three with a shot at finals on the line. And of course, you know the story that Ruben goes on to win this, goes on with his squad to win that world championship. But look at the play here from Moogie. Goes to the low inside part of that tower with the miner to get the hunter and archers both pointed his way and get those wall breakers on tower. That is beautiful micro and why everyone wanted to see this matchup. And that's why it's our number one play. That's it for our top 10. We'll see you next year with more Clash Royale League.